Are you a mindless or mindful eater? There are many reasons why diets fail, but today we'll focus on just one of those reasons. The way that diets and also the food industry drives us to focus on external cues. Now you might be saying, if I don't follow what the diet tells me to eat, I'll overeat. Over the next few minutes, I'm going to explain why that exact mentality that you believe helps you lose weight will actually most likely lead to you regaining weight after the diet is over. So the principle of most diets, fads, and point plans is that you are allocated what to eat, when to eat, and how much at each mealtime. Even though 95% of diets fail, this continues to be the foundation of almost all diets. Whatever the new name, whatever the new fad, it still fundamentally relies on the principle of making decisions for you on your eating. And most people buy into this and still believe it's the only way. We've all been told that self-denial and rigidly following a plan above all is the only way to stay slim. But what's actually happening in your subconscious is that the habits you are following to lose weight are the exact same habits that mean you will probably regain all of the weight and even more after you finish the diet. The fundamental reason that diets train you to gain weight is because they teach you to be reliant on external cues. This means you are subconsciously training yourself to ignore your levels of appetite, of your hunger and fullness signals, instead forcing yourself to eat exactly what is on a diet plan. By relying on external cues, three things happen. You completely disconnect from your internal cues. Am I hungry? Am I now satisfied? Is no longer part of your decision making. You learn to tolerate a level of hunger that is not normal. So your metabolism will go down throughout the diet, meaning it will be much easier to gain weight once you've completed the diet. You rely on visual cues. Is all the food gone? Rather than internal cues. Am I full enough? To illustrate the consequences of relying on external cues, there was an interesting experiment known as the bottomless bowl of soup experiment. The participants in this experiment were divided into two groups. The first group, a control group, were given standard bowls of soup. The second group were also given bowls of soup, but these were different. They were rigged. Each of the second group's set of bowls was connected to a pipe, and this pipe connected to a large supply of soup. So no matter how much the second set of participants ate, the bowl of soup always refilled itself. A never-ending supply. So what happened? The results were staggering. Of the participants, both male and female, both slim and overweight, the group with the bottomless bowls of soup ate an average of 73% more than those with the normal bowls. Not only that, but those with the refilling bowl of soup did not believe that they had eaten any more than those in the control group with the standard bowl of soup. Even more worrying, in repeats of this experiment, those with bottomless bowls of soup ate up to three times as much, 300% more than those with a standard bowl of soup. After the experiment, both sets of participants were asked for their feedback to see if they could accurately gauge why they ate, as well as their natural levels of appetite and fullness. What's interesting is that both groups overestimated their ability to gauge their appetite and fullness. Most of the control group finished their bowl of soup. This shows that we simply do not train ourselves well enough to use our natural appetite and fullness as the primary reason to decide how much to eat. So what does this tell us? That most of us, no matter what our weight, are relying on the wrong cues to know when to start and finish eating. A clean plate is overriding our natural appetite signals. This may not be a surprise given the rising rates of obesity, with two-thirds of the US population alone being overweight or obese. And the projected rates of obesity are predicted to increase until at least 2030. Yet we have more access to nutritional information than ever, and there are more diets out there than ever, so information alone is not enough. Of the 15 dimensions of a slim mindset that I have identified and included in the design of the Think Yourself Slim program, the first two are mindful eating and mind-body connection. Going back to the bottomless bowls of soup experiment, there were some telltale signs of mindless eating. See if any of these quotes by participants also apply to you. They stated phrases such as, "If other people are eating, I am more likely to do so." "I always try to clean my plate or bowl." "Eating with other people distracted me from how much I was eating." Do any of these resonate for you? So I hope it's becoming clearer now how the same diet mentality also leads you to overeat by relying on external cues instead of checking in with your natural appetite. By going on a diet, any habit that you had of checking in with your natural appetite has been broken and overridden by external cues. So ask yourself, how do you decide what to eat, when to eat, how much, and when to stop? This is why the Think Yourself Slim program is not a diet. It is a mindset change, helping you remove external dependencies, creating an inbuilt slim mindset with the power of hypnosis, guided meditations, affirmations, and the support of daily coaching. It ultimately gives you back your power so that at some point, after retraining your brain, you will not need the program anymore. It breaks down the old unhelpful habits, such as emotional attachment to food, and builds up new positive beliefs. So if you have realized through the course of this video that you do have tendencies of mindless eating or relying on external cues instead of your appetite, why not try out day one of the program today and start to relearn mindful eating, rebuilding mind-body connection? I'll put a link to the video in the description. And you can also try out part one of the Hypnotic Gastric Band collection, which is part of the extended Think Yourself Slim program, ideal for those who are compulsive overeaters, binge eaters, or have more than 30 pounds to shed. But remember, the mindset comes first. Focus on retraining your brain, and the weight loss will follow. To learn more about the program, go to thinkyourselfslim.com, where you can also read about my 10-year journey in developing this program to overcome my battle with eating disorders and constant dieting. My name is Sarah Dresser, clinical hypnotherapist, and I know that if I can do it, you too can retrain your brain to think yourself slim.